Hi, this is Raphael Mudge, the creator of Cobalt Strike. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate Pass the Hash with Mimikatz. Here we are in Cobalt Strike on Kali Linux. I have a system beaconing back as system, okay? Now, first things first, I'm going to dump hashes from the system, okay? And I'm going to attempt to pass the administrator hash. Now I want to prove to you that my current token, my current session has no special rights onto this target system, 172.168.83. So you can see when I try to do a directory listing on $, I get back access is denied. No special privileges. Now what we're going to do is we're going to use Mimikatz from Beacon, and we're going to use the sclrsa pass the hash command, and we're going to tell it to do the user. The domain, we'll just put a period for the local workstation, and we're going to give it the NTLM portion of this hash. Okay. Now, when you use the Mimikatz sclrsa pass the hash command, you have the option to specify what program it should run. And when you do this, Mimikatz will spawn that program with a modified access token that has the username and password hash you specify populated in that token's single sign-on fields. So what we're going to do is we're going to run PowerShell -w hidden. And the reason we're doing that is so Mimikatz runs a program, runs PowerShell without creating a window on the desktop. So here we can see that pass the hash succeeded, and Mimikatz is telling us which program it ran for us and which PID, process ID 3760. What I'm going to do is steal the token from that process, and you'll notice it's saying I stole the system token. Ignore that username, because what we're really interested in is the single sign-on portions of the token, not what the local system thinks the token is. So now let's go ahead and revisit our dir on 172.168.83. And you'll see we get back a directory listing. We have successfully passed the hash to authenticate that system and carry out a privileged action. Okay, pretty cool. Now let's try to use this for lateral movement. Let's go to attacks, packages, Windows executable S to export a stageless beacon executable. We'll do an SMB beacon, and in the spirit of PSExec, we'll just create a service executable. Let's go ahead and press generate. We're going to go ahead and call this demo.exe. And let's just go to a temp folder on this system. And let's upload demo.exe. And let's copy demo.exe over to our target. And we'll put it in C Windows temp. And let's create a service on our target. Okay. We'll call it demo pth, bin path equals C Windows temp. And we'll demo.exe. And let's start the service. And let's assume control of that beacon. And there you go. We've now taken control of a fully patched and up-to-date Windows 8.1 system by passing the hash with Mimikatz. What I like about this technique for passing the hash is I can do it asynchronously, meaning my beacons can have a high sleep time, never requiring me to have interactive command and control with the target's network. I also like this method because I don't have to just use pass the hash to run an executable. I can interrogate the target system just using native Windows commands. I can use dir to pull directory listings. I can copy files over to the current system and exfiltrate them from my foothold. So I get a lot more flexibility to achieve my objectives than just firing a PSExec module against the target. So that's my demo of Pass the Hash with Mimikatz. I hope you enjoyed it. Good luck and happy hacking.